Namaste viewers, welcome to Jnana Degula channel. In this episode, we will try to understand the meaning of Sādhārana Dharma. We saw in previous episodes the meanings of several dharma, several depending upon the circumstances, how one should follow dharmas, all those things. Today we will see this Sādhārana Dharma. It's an universal moral duties that are to be observed or that are to be followed. Sādhārana Dharma refers to the basic moral principles that apply to everyone, and this is regardless of their social position in the society, stage in life, whether they are young, middle aged, old age, like this, or personal situation. In whichever personal situation they are, they need to follow this Sādhārana Dharma. These are some kind of universal duties. They serve as the foundation of ethical living and help maintain harmony in society. These are all things, you know, which have been told in the ancient granthas, our ancient books, and then which we were following. Now, the important points here are, the foundation for this is universality. That means these duties are meant for all people, irrespective of caste, creed, religion, area, desha, kala, all those things, you know, without any exception. This is one. Then, this is based on moral foundation. So, the basic thing is, it provides a framework for personal and social behavior, for the welfare of everyone, for the goodness, or for a very harmonious and very peaceful living. And these are simple to follow also. It is very easily, it can be understood and very simple to follow also. This is the thing. Now, supposing if you want to, examples of such dharmas would be like this, you know. Non-violence. Ahimsa. Ahimsa means violent. Ahimsa means non-violent. Non-violence is avoiding or not harming others in any form. See, it's not only physically harming. You should not harm others. You should not harass them mentally. You should not harass them physically. You should not create situations where he will feel very uncomfortable for living, difficult for living, all those kinds of things, you know. These are some of the things, you know, which form this non-violence, and it is quite easy to follow also. If one confines himself to himself, there is no need for being violent on others. Now, the second thing is truthfulness, that is satya. It is always said that satya. Satyam Shivam Sundaram, they say. It is being honest in thoughts, words and actions. Very well explained, you know. Kaya, Vacha, Manasa. Manasa means thoughts. In the thoughts, you know, you have to think good up about others, or whatever that is there. Vacha, that means while speaking also. And then by Kaya, while acting. So, these are three things, you know, which form the basis for satya. Now, the next one is compassion, karuna, showing sympathy and care towards others. Whenever somebody is suffering, whenever somebody is suffering physically, or he has got some deep troubles mentally, he is disturbed mentally, you have to show empathy, you have to show, sympathize with them. That is one thing. This is compassion. Then self-control. Controlling one's emotions, desires and actions. We are all driven by a lot of emotions. We get angry, we get frustrated, we get joyous, we get all kinds of emotions are there. One has to control this, and then not that you should not exhibit this, but when you exhibit, you should ensure that it doesn't harm others. This is self-control. Even desires also. You also, we have as humans, as beings, we have a lot of desires. Desires of on material world. We want this, we want that, we want everything. Asha, we can't. See, we should have asha, but we should not have durasha. That means, you should not indulge in that. You should know that it's like a shared, the resources are to be shared by everyone in an equitable manner. Though not equal, the resources should be shared in an equitable manner. Whatever is necessary, you should only take it. You should ensure that others also get this. This is regarding desires. And actions. Actions also, you know. You feel angry on somebody. You cannot go and then just punch him and all those things. You should have some. You should refrain from doing certain things. This is self-control. So, Sādhārana Dharma acts as a moral guide. It helps individuals lead a righteous life and fostering positive contributions to society. By following these principles, people can live in harmony and contribute to the well-being of the society and well-being of the surroundings, well-being of all. So, viewers, with this, we conclude this episode on Sādhārana Dharma. I hope this was quite interesting. Please like, share and then subscribe to our channel. Thank you.